Hours after the results came down that President-elect Joe Biden has secured enough electoral votes, the celebration started pouring out in Georgia. We are here in Midtown Atlanta. Take a look behind me. These crowds have been building up for the last few hours. People are holding up signs. They're excited. They're cheering. They are honking their cars, and they never thought they would see the first African-American woman be a vice president of the United States. But the counting is still going on in Georgia. Fulton, Gwinnett, many other counties are still counting those military overseas ballots, those provisional ballots, because Georgia still has those Senate races that will count off in January and determine who gets control of the Senate. We talked to some people out here and they say, you know what? This is a historic moment, not just for Georgia, but also for the United States of America. And they say this time is time to change the U.S.
We just wanted to drive out hate, of course. I think that was the most important thing for me in this election, was just to send a message that hate won't be tolerated, racism won't be tolerated, bigotry won't be tolerated in this country. That's not what we're about.
There's two words that come into mind. Stacey Abrams. I mean, she said what she was going to do and she did it. Voter registration, voter knowledge, voter accessibility, all of those things are very important. And she went after it. Her, not just her, she had a great team of people.
I am just so happy and elated that we showed this country that black people, we get out, we vote, we are not going to tolerate racism.
Georgia has not voted for a Democratic president since 1992 during Bill Clinton's presidency. And while the crowds outside continue to get bigger and bigger, people inside are still counting those provisional and military ballots, including Fulton County, Gwinnett County. They did have a bit of an issue with the Dominion system there, but they're going to be working through the weekend to get all of those votes counted. John Ossoff faces David Perdue. Kelly Loeffler faces Democrat Raphael Warnock. Those now go to a runoff January the 5th. So Georgia now is a center, front and center when it comes to who gains control of the U.S. Senate. Reporting in Atlanta, Archith Seshadri, Atlanta Bureau Chief.